Hey guys, Ivan here. So if you're wondering what Milos Sarcev's physique looks like today, you're gonna find out in this video. So I have a couple of photos and a video as well. So you're gonna see what his shape is today. I mean, 20 years after he retired, basically. You guys know that Milos is 90s bodybuilder. And about 20 years later, he looks in a pretty good damn shape. Now, of course, this photo right here is not from 2020. 2020 started only 12 days ago. So it's 2019, 2018, but you get the idea. I mean, this is what he looks like today. So here you can see that he is very well conditioned. Look at those abs. Look at that stomach. Look at it here. I mean, look at the legs. The conditioning is spot on. I can say that he kept more muscle and better conditioning than Kevin Levroni, for example, when he made his comeback, comparing their physiques today to what they were during the 90s. So Milos really kept a lot of muscle and great conditioning. So obviously he's dieting, but I know he has crazy fast metabolism as well. You can probably notice that his biceps, his arms are not looking that aesthetic. And that's probably because of that Sintel use that he did in the end of his career. But overall, he looks pretty freaking impressive. I mean, look at him. Look at the conditioning. Look at all the muscle. Now, I watched an interview with him in Serbian language, and you probably wouldn't be able to understand it because most of you are not from around here. But by the way, yeah, Milos is from Serbia, and I'm also from Serbia. He is by far the best bodybuilder from around here, from not only Serbia, but Balkans as well. There was also Nasser Elsambari, who represented Yugoslavia during the 90s when he was competing. But Nasser's father was Egyptian, and I don't think he grew up in Serbia. I never really heard an interview of himself talking in Serbian. And as far as Milos, I know exactly the town when he was born. I know the gym where he started training. And I know that that whole town is all about him. In every gym, you will see a bunch of photos everywhere or on all the walls. A lot of posters, a lot of photos of himself. They're looking at him like a god. And that town has a lot of competitors, especially considering that the town has only 50,000 people living in there. So Milos Sarcev really did an impact on that town and also on Serbia. But anyways, this is another photo of himself, of his physique. So basically you can see, he kept pretty much all of his mass. He has great abs, great conditioning, chest is full. We can't really see his back, but you can see his legs in the photo before. His arms are still damaged a little bit from all that Sintel use that destroyed his physique basically back when he was competing and forever basically. So in that interview that I watched, that I was telling you about before, he was talking about the doses that he's using today, and he's still on the stuff. He never stopped. He says that as long as he is on, half of that time he is off. And that's what he is doing. If he's 3 months on, he's a month and a half off, 2 months on, 1 month off, 4 months on, 2 months off, and he never stops. He never stops, and he never plans on stopping. He's not doing TRT. He's doing cycles. And he still trains like a maniac. I have a friend that saw him 2018 in this gym, in this town where he comes sometimes. That's the town where he was born and he comes occasionally. So he came in Serbia 2018 and this friend of mine saw him training and he says that he was training like a maniac. He did the giant sets. You would assume that he is a retired bodybuilder, so he doesn't really train hard. He doesn't eat properly. He doesn't use the stuff, but apparently he's on the cycles constantly. He's certainly eating properly, I'm sure about that. I didn't really hear him talking about that, but yeah, he's definitely eating properly. And this guy that saw him training, this friend of mine, he told me that he was training super intensely. He said something like that was the most intense training session that he ever saw in person. So imagine that, being 55, 56 years old today and still training, doing the giant sets and everything and still forcing himself super hard. And that's why he looks like this. He wouldn't look like this if he wasn't doing that. I'm sure you guys know about his photo. I'm sure you saw it before. It's a very popular photo and there's a story behind it. You can find it on the Jay Cutler TV YouTube channel where Milos was talking about it, but I'm sure it's hard to find it. And it's a long story. It's not really that much of a story. It's not that interesting, but basically these guys got together in a hotel room before the show. And they just took this photo. I mean, Milos was showing his legs and his abs and a little bit of his pec, right? And Jay was there, you know, ready for the show, tanned up, oiled up and everything. And today, well, not exactly today, I believe this was like 2019, early 2019, I believe. These guys took another photo, pretty much the same kind. And the story behind this one is rather interesting. So Milos asked Jay Cutler, "Do you still have abs?" And Jay replied, "Always." So they took their shirts off. Actually, they just lifted the shirts up and took this photo. And they both have great abs, great set of abs. They're not fat at all. They don't have any fat right there. I only see skin and muscle. So it's amazing. I mean, these bodybuilders never really gave up on being strict, regimented, at least a little. Not as much as they were before. I'm sure about that, of course. Of course. But still, they look great. They look great. They're both in shape, very good shape. They hold a lot of muscle and in great conditioning. If you're crazy about bodybuilding, such as myself, I'm sure you watched this entire video before. And this was the moment where Milos showed his abs to Luke. And basically, he has better set of abs than Luke, for sure. So still, today, at 55 or 56 years old, Milos still has great set of abs. Much better than Dorian or any other 90s bodybuilder. So Milos is definitely in a great shape. And if I didn't tell you already, his name is pronounced Milos Sarcev. So Milos sh like shorts, Sarcev ch like chair. Milos Sarcev. I understand if you're American, you probably won't know how to pronounce it properly. But just in case you wanted to learn it, now you know. Milos Sarcev. And so this is basically his shape, this is what he looks today. He's still in great shape. He could compete still at Masters, Mr. Olympia or something like that. He looks amazing, he looks phenomenal. He's in great shape. His body looks like he's 20 or something. Obviously, he never stopped training. He kept training very hard. That workout that my friend saw in 2018 was a leg workout. So he still crushes his legs. And here you can see that they're looking huge for somebody of his age. So many years after retirement. And oral conditioning is super impressive. Everything is just spot on. Probably a bodybuilder that held the most amount of his muscle from the 90s. And I may make a video about that. What are all the 90s bodybuilders doing today and what are they looking like? Anyways, in case you were wondering, now you know what he looks like. He's in great shape. Tell me what you think down below in the comment section. Like the video if you enjoyed it and please subscribe for more bodybuilding videos like this. All the best guys and bye bye.